In the name of Jesus Christ, to reveal yourself to us all, so that we will really know the God we are serving. That is a great God. It's a mighty God. It's a God that loves his people. God requires us also to give back that love to him. Father, thank you, Lord. Please reveal yourself deeply to us, so that we will really take you seriously in our life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. God bless you all. In the name of Jesus. So today, thank you, Holy Spirit. Yeah. God bless you. We are going to give the word of God this hour. So the message God has for us today, no one who waits for God's help will be what? Disappointed. Hallelujah. May God help us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. So that we will teach the world and the Spirit of God direct us in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, I avail myself to you this hour. Speak through me. Give me your word to your people. Use my mouth to bless them this hour. Father, help them, Lord. Enable them to open their heart to receive your word. Father, you are so great. You are so mighty. You are so powerful, God. Father, come into our hearts this hour. Let our hearts be open. Let our ear be open to receive your word inside us. To run with your word. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, your word is A and Amen. Those that believe in you, those that wait upon you, they will never be disappointed. Father, this hour, use my mouth as your mouthpiece to speak to your people. Use me to empower them in the name of Jesus Christ. Use my mouth to encourage them and let them stand firm in your word. And let them stand firm in you and know that God has never disappointed his true children. Father, this hour, I disappear so that you appear for your people's life. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, every carnality in my life, I command it to be stripped out away in my life right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, what you are not going to speak today, may my mouth not say it, oh God. Father, put a gap in my mouth, guide my mouth, oh God, to speak only your word, whatever that will offend your children this hour. May it not come out from my mouth in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I decree and I declare, I put devil and his agent under our feet. That is where they belong. We can every enemy perpetually in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, speak through your children today. Speak to them. Let them run with your word. Let them obey your word in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, this hour, Lord, as you are about to bring your word forth, Father, may your word come with your presence. May your word come with your authority. May your word come with power. Father, give me utterance of your word. Give me inspiration of your word. Give me revelation of your word. I need wisdom, oh God, above all. In the name of Jesus Christ, I need insight of your word, mighty God. Father, reveal yourself to me this hour. Take over me, Lord. May your spirit take over me and speak to your children as never before. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We bless you, Lord. We commit this service into your able hand. Father, take absolute control because you are a great God. Thank you, Father. You are great, yes, you are. Only one. Jesus. Walk upon the sea, you raised the dead. You reign in majesty, mighty God. Ah, everything about you is great.
You are great. Everything about you.
Demons tremble at your presence. What a mighty God we serve. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Everything about you is real. Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, we didn't deserve the mercy. Father, mercy. You are a God of mercy. We have still left people. I know. Mercy. Don't turn your back on us, Father. We need you. Now. Before Jesus left to heaven, he said, in this world, you will face tribulation. In this world, you will face troubles and trial. In this world, you will face problem. But he says, shut up, because I have overcome the trouble for you. Hallelujah. Amen. The trouble I've been overcome long ago. But the only way for you to be restored back, or for God to show you mercy, or for God to favor you, is for you to to stand firm in God. It's for you to wait in God. It's for you to be patient in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's very important for the believers to be patient in God, to wait patiently for God. Without that, no one will see God. Because in this world we are living, many of us can no longer be patient. We want the things now, 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 now. But things don't work that way. Hallelujah. Things don't work that way. God is a God of mercy. God do his own things at his own time. Not the time you want it. The time he know that is good for you. The time he know that is better for you. Because why? He's a God of the universe. He's a God that created the whole wide world. He know when you need it. Because there is some blessing that will come to you now. If it's not yet your time, you cannot handle that blessing. You will misuse that blessing, or that same blessing will take your life prematurely. Are you hearing me? That same blessing will take your life, what? Prematurely. But because God so loves you, he will make you enjoy to his own timing, that he know that it's a due season for his own time to give you that blessing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So sometimes also our sin can also delay our blessing. Sometimes God also can still delay the blessing because of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today, God is good. He's a good God that always restores his people back again. That always gives his people great blessing. That always heals his people. Whatever you need, God will deliver you. May God heal you. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever disease you bring here today, you will not go back the same.
Amen.
You are healed in Jesus'
name.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
God healed his people. He will deliver you.
Amen.
That disease will disappear.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, the God we are serving is a good God. So, the Bible said in the book of Isaiah 49, verse 8, going, I read. He said, the Lord said to his people, when the time comes to save you, I will show you favor and answer your cry for help. Are you saying it? Because if God don't have his time, he will not use that word, when the time come. People of God, God have his time. Be patient for God's time. Don't force God to do what he don't want to do now. He has his time. He said, when the time come, he will hear your cry for help and he will favor you. The time of God is the best. Remember, people of God, when God bless someone, he will have no sorrow to it. Because the favor of God, he will endure forever. He will last. He will give you eternal joy. He will give you peace. The happiness you are looking for. When you ask people, they will just, if I can be happy, I will just be okay. Happiness will just come for a while and disappear. All you need is joy. That's why the Bible said, the joy of the Lord is our strength. You will be happy now. The next week you are empty. You yourself, you don't know what is going on in your life because you are not filled, you are not fulfilled because you are lacking something, which is Jesus Christ. It's only Jesus Christ that can give you peace. It's only Jesus Christ that can give you joy. It's only Jesus Christ that can give you everything you want. Hallelujah. He will give it to you. Even those things your heart desire is not coming now. But there is one thing he will give you to strengthen you. Joy. Are you seeing it? A lot of us, we are going through trouble, through persecution, whatever it may be, trial, disappointment, rejection, frustration, name it all. Without the joy of God, you will see yourself that you are already in hell. Are you seeing it? But when God gives you joy, despite the situation you are facing, you will be calm. You will be encouraged. You will be strengthened. You will have what? Peace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So people of God, you need the peace of God. You need the joy of God. Hallelujah. He said that we hear your cry from God, I will show you favor. I will hear your cry for help. I will guide you and protect you. And through you make a covenant with all peoples. I will let you settle once again in your land that is now laid wasted. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A lot of us, many of us even have what we are looking for. Money, material things, you have it, but it's of no use now for you. Because the challenges you are facing, the disease, the sickness you are experiencing, even people that is poor now, you wish you want to be like them. Because why? All those things is of no use for you. Because you are lacking one thing, Jesus Christ. It's only Jesus Christ that can fill that empty place. Remember, the Bible said, your sickness, if you are in Christ, your sickness is not like other people. Are you hearing it? Because your sickness is to strengthen your desire for God. No wonder Apostle Paul said, 3 times I plead with our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, take this storm away from me. He said, my grace is sufficient for you. Your sickness will not kill you. Other people may kill them because why? They don't have Christ. But because you have Christ, your own is to make you know Christ more. It's to draw you closer to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All you need today is to give your life to Christ. Is to rededicate your life to Christ. Is to accept Jesus Christ so that that empty place that is empty, you yourself, you don't know why that place is so empty. You can't figure it out. It's only Jesus that can fill it for you. Come to me today. Open your heart. Let him feed you with his word. Let him give you the grace that will help you. Hallelujah. We need grace. We all need grace of God. Without his grace, our problem will wipe us away. But with his grace in you, you will walk through that problem and come out for that problem and turn back and see that problem. You will say, is it me, really me that come out from this situation? It's you, because you with God is majority. You alone with God is what? It's majority. Praise God. Verse 9, I will say to the prisoner, go free, and to those who are in darkness, come out to light. That is his word. I will say to the prisoner, go free. He will set you free. Meaning of darkness, it can be whatever it may be, situation, sickness, disease, problem, trouble, agony, rejection, pain, whatever. Anything that has seen like darkness is trouble. Hallelujah. It's trouble, but it's telling you today, I will bring you out. Only one on one condition. Receive Christ into your hearts. Hallelujah. It will fill that empty place. It will give you everlasting joy. Joy that you cannot even explain. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You need joy, not happiness. Happiness will fly away like butterfly, but joy is forever. Peace is forever. All you need is peace and joy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He will bring you to light. That is his light. He will bring you what? To light. You need light today. In the name of Jesus Christ. They will be like sheep that graze on the hill. 10. They will never be hungry or thirsty. Are you hearing him? When you accept him fully, open your heart. Be patient. Don't be anxious for nothing. Are you hearing it? Just wait for him. Let his time come on your life. Because if you are too anxious, you will go astray. If you want it now, you are too desperate, you will lose your faith in God. You must know how to be patient. Hallelujah. You must know what? How to be patient. So that when the time comes, it will help you. He said, you will never go hungry. You will never go thirsty. Sun and desert, it will not hurt you. Will not harm you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Meaning that trouble, whatever it may be, it will not kill you. It will come. It's not that it will not come, but you will not die. You will walk through it. People will know that you have God. Are you hearing me, people of God? That is his word. For they will be led by one who loved them. He will lead them to a spring of water. Have you went through rejection? People you give your love to, have they abandoned you? Have they reject you? Did they forsake you? Because they see, they believe in their eyes, human eyes, that nothing good can come out of you. They leave you. I wish they have spiritual eyes to see. They will not abandon you. They will not forsake you. They will not leave you. They will stand by you. Because there is something about you. You are a chosen one of God.
Hallelujah.
If they know they have eyes to see your destiny, they will not go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is telling you today, he will bring people that will truly love you,
Amen. That
will help you,
Amen.
That will carry you,
Amen.
And lead you by the way.
Amen.
His word will not go back to him.
Amen.
You will find love again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will find joy again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That man, that woman that abandoned you, that believe that there nothing good can come out of you, then we try to come back again. But yeah, God said they can never enter your life again.
Amen.
Because they are distraction.
Amen.
Real people will come back to you.
Amen.
God is saying, we bring good people into your life.
Amen.
That will favor you.
Amen.
That will bless you.
Amen.
That will be by your side.
Amen.
You will never feel loneliness again.
Amen.
You will never feel rejection again.
Amen.
Because why? The time of God has come in your life.
Amen.
Receive it, people of God.
Amen.
Be blessed by his word.
Amen.
11, I will make a highway and run across the mountain and prepare a road for you, my people, to travel. 12, my people will come from far away, from the north and the east and from the south. 13, sing heaven, shout for joy. Earth, let the mountain burst into song. The Lord will comfort his people. He will have pity on his suffering people. Do you think God is not seeing your suffering? Huh? Do you think he's not seeing it? He's seeing every single tear that be dropping in your eyes secretly. God is seeing them all. He knows the kind of pains, agony, situation, whatever you are going through. He knows your suffering. He knows your loneliness. He knows your rejection. He sees them all. The funny things of it all, many of you have been fasting, praying, seeking his face. It seems like God is not hearing you. God wants you to pass through it. When you are passing through the process of God, prayer will no longer be answered at that time. Fasting will no longer be answered at that time. Your giving will no matter what you do, will no longer be answered. I'm not saying prayer is not good. I'm not saying fasting is not good. All the word of God must surely what? Come to pass. All his word must surely come to pass. But it's time, it's timing. When he wants you to have experience, to know him better, to understand who is him. You that used to pray, you know when you give your life to Christ, whatever you say, everyone will hear immediately. They will grant it for you. You will think you are top of the world. you will think that you are most the prayerful person in the whole wide world. You will think God so loves you too much. That's why your prayer has been answered. Because, yes, He will do that for you to bring you to Himself. After that, He will what? He will start training you. Are you hearing it? He will do what? He will start training you. You need to grow. Because you cannot continue to be drinking milk. You need to crack bones. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when God now wants to make you know Him better, if you like, be running to anywhere you want to go to, you must still come back and wait. Because those that really love God, they will come back again and surrender to God. Father, lead me. But those that don't know God, that is where they give up their faith. They will say that I'll be praying and be fasting. I don't know what else to do. I am tired. They will throw their faith away. But those that truly love God, they will go back again to God. Father, what is my problem? Father, lead me by the way. You will be surrounded to God. Then He will start leading you. Then He will give you joy. Then He will have pity on your suffering. Are you seeing it? Then He will not grant your heart desire. All is a process for you to know Him better. When you now know Him better, when you see people that is passing through that same problem, you will not have a message for them. Without test, there is no exam. And without exam, there is no result. Meaning that people of God, wait patiently for God. Be calm. If you have been praying for years, your prayer is not answered. Do you think God is so wicked? No. He's a good God. He's a compassionate God. He wants you to search deeply into your heart what you are lacking. There is one thing you are lacking. You don't want to wait. There is no shortcut in the kingdom of God. Everybody must walk through the experience of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
14. But the people of Jerusalem said, "The Lord has abandoned us. He has forgotten us." 15. So the Lord answered, because it's just like the way me and you, we are saying, the Lord has abandoned us. The Lord has forsaken us. We have been praying. We have been fasting. But everything is not answering. God answered them. May God answer you today.
Amen.
May God speak to you today.
Amen.
When you go to your secret place to pray, ask God to reveal your thoughts to you. He's a good God. When you pray, sometimes you may pray, God may not speak that day, but continue. He will surely reveal your fault to you so that you will come back to Him. You know what He said? They are complaining. God have abandoned us. God have forsaken us. But God answered, can a mother forget her own baby? Can you forget your own children? Can you forget your own children? God answered them, can a mother forget her own baby and not love the child he she bears? Can a mother forget her own child? He will no longer love a child that he she gave birth to. God answered them was a question. God said, even if a mother should forget a child, I, God, will never forget you.
Amen.
What a wonderful God we serve. Even your own mother rejected you, me, God, will never reject you.
Amen.
To see how lovely God is, all you just need, dedicate yourself to Him. Wait for Him, because His time is the best in your life. No matter what you are facing, always remember one thing in this message today. God's timing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
His time will surely come true. Just wait. Be using that to encourage yourself. My time will come. My time will come. My time will come. All those torments, all those things that is going through your mind, we go down. We be calm. Because why? Because all the enemy is trying to use it so that you'll be anxious. But always say with your mouth, confess with your mouth that my time will come. Hallelujah. God said to you today, even though your own parents reject you, even though they forget about you, me, God, your Father, your Creator, I will not forget you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Mm-hmm.
16, Jerusalem, I can never forget you. He repeats it again. People of God, God said, I can never forget you. Thank you, Father. I have written your name on the palms of my hands.
Hallelujah.
Are you seeing it? Your name is in the hands of God. He writes it there. He is there. He is saying it every day. One thing is waiting for you is for you to wait and set your mind in the things of heaven, not on the things of this world. Hallelujah. Let your mind be focused on Him alone. Your name is in His palms. Praise God. Thank you, Father. He said, those who will rebuild you are coming soon. Hallelujah. Those who will rebuild you, because people think you are a failure. People think you are a loser. People think that you are good for nothing. That is what they are. Carnal eyes can see, but their spiritual eyes cannot go to the spirit realm to really know who you are. They are coming. God is telling you, they are coming on their way to rebuild you.
Amen.
Because, and those who destroy you will go. It's His word. His word can never go back to Him. A lot of us, we have been destroyed by so people also, we believe they love us. That same people have destroyed us. Hallelujah. People that we believe that they love you so much, they are the one the enemy also used to want to destroy you. But he's telling you today, the one that will rebuild you, people of God, is coming. And the one that have destroyed you, he will send them away forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. They can never, there is no way for them to come, because you are too occupied. You are too, you God, the favor of God is too much in your life. There is no space for them to enter. Praise God. This is a prayer for you today. Many people have been destroyed by people they love, but God will send them away. God will bring people that will rebuild you. He said, look around and see what is happening now. Many people cannot see what is happening now. If you can see what is happening now, you will know that there is God in your life. You don't need a prophet to speak. Open your eyes, open it widely. You will see what is taking place in the realm of the spirit. Hallelujah. God will bless a lot of people that know how to endure to the end with people they love. Hallelujah. Really, God will bless the people. Because when you reject people, the same people you abandoned, you rejected, you now find out that God have lifted them up. Power have changed hands. You know it's a shameful thing to look at them. People, of course, it's very shameful to see them. Many people have taken their life because of rejection. Please, what I want you to pray today, pray that God should open your eye to know who you are in the spirit realm. Hallelujah. If you know who you are in the spirit realm, you will not give up your faith. Because even the physical is telling you that there is no hope for you. But in the spirit, you are seeing that there is hope. You need, the realm of the spirit is greater than this realm we are living. Hallelujah. Because whatever that take part or whatever that happen in the spirit realm, if you believe and you know the God that has shown you that dreams, that vision, and stand by his word, no matter how long it takes, it will surely come to pass. The reason many of us throw away our belief, because we don't have eye to see deep in the spirit. When people write us off, when people cut us off, we think all head is loose and all hope is gone. We will take our lives. Don't take your life. There is hope. Even the tree they have cut down, there is still hope in that tree. In our home, in our house, we call one of our family friends, but he has passed away, is the old man. We call him Papa. He has departed. He come to cut all the flowers because he was too grown. So one day, he cut them very short. One day, when I go through our windows, I was looking. Then my eyes go through to that flower. I look, and the Spirit of God is telling me, can't you see this flower? Can't you see? I was looking. Say, can't you see that this flower has been cut for some time? Can't you see that you have grown again? Because me, I could not remember that flower has been cut because you have so grown, even grown bigger than before. Because I could not see, but the Spirit of God remembered me that, can't you see that flower? That flowers have been cut short since, but can't you see? I have been grown again. So God bring my attention back to there. Then I told my husband, I said, what? So that means there is hope for those that have been put down. I told him that, I said, no wonder the Bible said, a righteous man will fall seven times. He will surely rise again. Are you down today? Your rising is coming.
Amen.
It's on its way.
Amen.
You will rise again.
Amen.
There is a hope for a tree that will be cut down.
Yes.
It will grow back again.
Amen.
Because why? God is with you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because of time, let me just quickly run down to it. He said, your country was rent and desolate, but now it will be too small for those who are coming to live there, and those who left you in rain will be far removed from you. Hallelujah. Your country, your life now look desolated, look like there is nothing good can ever come out in your life. But it will be repeated again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Those that abandoned you, those that left you in your situation, those that left you because they believe with their physical eye that there's nothing good can come out in your life, God is speaking to you today that you will be rebuilt.
Amen.
That those that left you, they will forever be removed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, is the word of God. It's not our world. Don't let that time come. People will try to manipulate you that you don't know how to forgive. You know how to forgive. God has removed them perpetually. There is no space for them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Your people who were born in exile will one day say to you, this land is too small. You need more room to live in. Hallelujah. Time will come. People will be saying, this church is too small. This house is too small.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We need more room to bring people in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need more room to bring people in. In your life, so shall it be for you also. Time will come. People in your life will come back to you. Hallelujah. People in your life, good one, that have stand by you, but maybe they don't really know what is going on, but they still stick by you. They will say to you that this This as you are living, I think it's too small for the people God have given to you. People God, the orphans God have given to you to be taken care of. I think this building is too small. Let us build a big mansion for them. Praise God. Thank you, Father. 21. He said, then you will say to yourself, who bear all those children for me? I lost my children and could have no more. I was exiled in and drive away. Who brought those children up? I was left all alone. Where did those children come from? Hallelujah.
Amen.
A lot of us, we are left all alone. Everybody in your life has dumped you. They are abandoned you. They are left you. You don't, when you look left, look right, look everywhere, just seem like you are just alone. But you will say to yourself, who brought all those children for me? Who born them for me? Who bring them to me? Hallelujah. The Lord is saying, the serving Lord said to his people, I will signal to the nation, and they will bring your children home. King will be like fathers to you. Queen will be like mothers. They will bow low before you and honor you. They will humbly show their respect for you. Then you will know that I am the Lord. Praise God. People is looking down on you today. People is disrespecting you. They despise you because they believe that nothing good can come out for you. But God is telling you today, because He is God, queens and kings will bow for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They wish all of them will show their respect for
Amen.
You. Remember, His word can never go back to Him. Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
He said, then you will know that I am your God. Yeah, the message is coming from. No one who waits for God's help can be ever be disappointed. Anyone that waits for his help will never be disappointed. If you truly wait today for him, you will never be disappointed. Just wait. Hallelujah. Wait. If you wait for him, you will never be disappointed. That is where the message is coming from. Praise Jesus. Because of time, let's be on our feet. Let me just wait for you. Be on your feet. Thank you, Lord. 25 to 26, I read. The Lord replied that is just what is going to happen to you. Kings and queens will bow for you. Everyone will show their honor to you. That is what is going to happen to you. That is His word. He said, His soldiers. Prisoner will be taken away. I will fight against whoever that fight against you. And I will rescue your children.
Amen.
I will make your oppressor kill each other. They will be drunk with murder and rage. Meaning they will be drunk with their own blood and they will eat their flesh. Thank you, Lord. Then all people will know that I am the Lord, the one who saved you and set you free.
Amen.
Then we know that I am your God.
Hallelujah.
Is that not a wonderful promise?
Amen.
People of God, all you need today, wait. Hallelujah. Don't be discouraged.
Amen.
Wait for God. Thank you, Father. Let's worship God. I have decided to follow.